Hello everyone, we're at Pocket Gamer Connects London 2023. I'm Dylan from HyprMex, and I'm joined by Ruslan from GAMEPACK. Ruslan, welcome.
Yeah, thanks.
Perfect. Well, to kick things off, why don't you tell us a little bit more about yourself, you know, GAMEPACK, about the company and the services you provide.
Yeah. My name is Ruslan Zelensky, so I'm from Ukraine, based. I'm founder of GAMEPACK company. We are 7 years old. I'm in the past was a general artist. Then I don't know, something's happened, and I look around, and I have a small team. And during 5 years, we grow an outsource company, and we grow each year twice. And then we reach 100 people, and we work with famous clients like Social Point, Outfit7, Supercell, and Playrix, Metacore. And then 2 years ago, we started in the product department, and we work in hyper casual. We create 80 games, but none of them successful. But it was a very good experience for us, and we opened another opportunity, like working with a partner on merch free game, and now it's on the soft launch. It's called Candy Merch, and it looks very amazing and shows very amazing retention metrics. And we expect the global launch at the end of this year.
Oh.
And we still grow in outsourcing department. So that's something like this.
Yeah, for sure. And I just want to dial back. So you'd mentioned that you're originally from Ukraine and your company is originally based in Ukraine.
Yeah,
maybe you can talk more about the situation that's going on over there and some of the challenges you faced over the last, you know, 6-12 months.
Yeah. 2022, it was a nightmare especially for Ukrainian and for all of the world. And we continue living in this horrible situation. War is not stopped, and Russia is not stopping bombing our houses and killing our kids. But we don't give up, and we still fighting for our freedom. And also in our company, we feel like a part of this fighting, part of this war, because we have a war in our company, because we are fighting for independence of our country. We are fighting for that our people can receive money, can spend money and buy some product, and we are growing our economic a little bit, because war is not only weapons, it's money also. And also we try to support our people how much it's possible. So we're working on this, and it was really difficult year for us and especially for our company.
For sure. I know there's a lot of challenges that you faced over the last year, so kudos to you for, you know, being able to move past them and continue to operate normal. I guess backtracking before, you mentioned you'd held previous roles, you know, at like Playrix and my.com, for example.
Yeah, as I mentioned, I in the past, before I started operation this company, I work in 5 or 6 years like an artist in the game development company. I am working with a few companies which they are clients now, like Playrix or different. Yeah, and it was a very good experience, because at that moment where I was like a general artist, no name, and working like a number 784, and after a few years, we are one of the major outsourcing partners for players, and also we are talking about some close cooperation. But during the war, players closed all outsourcing work with other company. I think they need some time to reorganize company and move from Russia. I think it's for them it's a very good idea not to stay in this country. And and now we work with them like a partnership, so it's interesting experience. I also give it the interview. I became a founder from usual artist. It was a hard and difficult time, but it's possible. Because I have a dream to work in the game development industry, not only like artist, but I want to build out my own company, which was very successful and will have a successful product in the market.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, you having an artist background, you know, more forward looking into 2023, are there any unique challenges or trends that you're seeing in the market? And, you know, what is your company doing specifically to hone in on them?
Now we're looking very, very big jump in the AI industry, like Midjourney. Designer to show the idea more clarified, more specifically to next production team.
Got it.
So I think it's the future. We need to find use to how to use in the production, and you will be successful.
Yeah, sounds interesting for sure. And this gets me to the last question that we have here. You know, 2023. You know, we closed the books on 2022.
Yeah.
What else can we look for from you and GAMEPACK in this coming year?
We started working like outsourcing company, but we want to be also famous like a product company. And now we're waiting to global release our mercenary game. But I think at the end this year we start new product in the mobile casual area. So we have a goal. Now we're 7 years old, and we have a goal to 10 years old to be a successful game developer.
So, yeah, lots to look forward to. You know, we're looking forward to hearing what you have in store for the year. And, you know, thank you again for jumping on for this fireside chat.
Yeah, thanks for inviting.
Of course.
Have a good day.
Appreciate it. You too.